Human Types, Meritum. The best way to describe the psychosis-hylomorphism or energy type identified as meritum would be as a partiality or bias towards merits and responsibility. This might sound somewhat vague and universal, so it is important to understand that bias towards merits and responsibility means that it often comes at the expense of pretty much everything else. Think of it as being similar to the Jungian function of extroverted thinking, which is analytical, committed, responsible, and hardworking. Except meritum is an energy that not only wants to take responsibility and be the best, but wants their entire behavior and existence to reflect and perform like a higher example in the culture. Unlike ruthlessness and hard-minded rawness, which is expansive and leads to unhinged actions and violence, a meritorious and responsible energy is more self-controlled, orderly, and sophisticated. However, a desire to achieve, be responsible, and strive higher must also orient itself around something that would be considered constructive or higher, and meritum is primarily a desensitized sensory motor energy, not an innovative, exploratory, and visionary sapientiam energy. Thus, the orientation towards something higher tends to be based on external standards and superior norms.
I felt morally superior. There is a certain satisfaction in thinking that your views are, whether or not they're right or wrong, they are morally superior, morally justified.
Meritum, of course, means merit, and refers to an orientation towards cultural elitism and superiority. An alternative name for the instinct is adorationem, which means adoration or admiration, since an eye towards merits also entails a strong admiration for culture and certain people. By looking at its position on this conceptual map, the tool we employ to make it easier to recall the context, relation, and nature of these character phenomena, we see that meritum is located in the morem sphere at the left plus column. Since the lower sphere of morem represents minus and still dominates in this energy, meritum, being minus plus, can thus be said to be the reflection of the higher sphere in the lower sphere. So just like with abstractum in the upper right corner, meritum in the lower left corner is a mixture of morem and sapientiam, except meritum is primarily a morem instinct and thus closer to exidium than to fiduciam. The effect is mostly that meritum becomes more focused on civilization and idealism than exidium. Hence the elated desire to perform according to something higher than mere selfish instinct in meritum, in contrast to exidium, which is more oriented towards personal desires and the primitive. That is not to say that meritum lacks selfishness or is the complete opposite of exidium. In fact, you could say that rather than trying to fit in and please other people by adhering to norms, the meritum energy wants to use norms and rules as a means of control or to get the privileges they feel they deserve by being the best and the most responsible.
And since I'm paying for it, it's Dave's rules. And Dave's rules are, you know, we're not sleeping around, we don't do drugs, we're going to church, and we're walking a righteous, clean life. You know better.
Yes,
we
sir.
Taught
Thank you
at home. Don't be one of the stupid ones. Now, be a man, and man make manly decisions, and that's the ability to delay pleasure for a greater good. And in soldiering, that's what you're doing, and in saving, that's what you're doing. You're delaying pleasure for a greater good. It is an indication of emotional maturity.
So just like you could say that abstractum is a modified fiduciam, you could say that meritum is a modified exidium, where the elated imagination and visions in fiduciam, as well as the dissatisfaction with reality, transforms meritum into a desire to elate the world and improve it on a concrete and tangible level. This is what makes meritum impose their norms and standards onto society, regardless of whether other people agree with these or not. In contrast to the greatum types, who more adapt to current fashions and trends, and care a great deal what other people value and think. Thus, just like abstractum, they can be somewhat remote from ordinary people, and can also be regarded as independent, just like the other types in the corners of the model. However, unlike fiduciam, abstractum, and exidium, Meritum types seem to be more common among women. This combination of desire for achievement, merit, and independence in a mostly female type explains the origin of feminism and why women seem to be more common in politics than in scientific or innovative professions. Most of my examples of this type are Swedish politicians, since I'm more familiar with our government, but UK's Margaret Thatcher, Theresa May, and America's Elizabeth Warren are some international examples. I'm actually a bit surprised that there aren't more Meritum women among American presidential candidates, but I guess their rigidity doesn't make them entertaining or bold enough for the American mindset. Eleanor Roosevelt, however, is a famous first lady.
Purpose of the National Recovery Act is to bring us back to prosperity, but we want a prosperity which will make life more worth living.
And there are company executives like Kathleen Kennedy, president of Lucasfilm. With that said, and because Meritum is a type that admires and values high culture, it is possible to find creative and intellectual examples of this type, such as philosophers Bertrand Russell and Ludwig Wittgenstein, or scientists like Richard Dawkins. And you also have some actors and actresses, and even comedians.
If you count back 2,000 years, as I have on my fingers many times, you will realize that this is the real start of the millennium.
But how many people will really be celebrating?
Anyone who revels in being technically correct. We're going to start off with a long explanation of why people who celebrated last year were wrong, followed by self-congratulation, and then we'll finish off with some assorted pedantry and a discussion of continuity errors in famous films.
Do you think anyone cares about this niggling obsession with accuracy? Surely the important thing is a nominal date of celebration where we join together as one community to celebrate an event regardless of when it actually occurred.
Louise, if I may, I'd just like to point out the four strict grammatical errors you made in that sentence.
The influence of secondary energies will play a part in what they gravitate towards. With libidinum in the configuration, they can be confused with libidinum types, especially the women. But you can usually tell the difference in that Meritum is less girly and more adult, or mommish.
Hey guys, I saw a bit of your production of Alien, and I just want to say it looked incredible. You put so much heart and soul into that. Bravo, well done.
Sigourney Weaver's presence and admiration for the kids who did the Alien school play, I think shows this appreciative love that Meritum often have for people. And it does not have to be extraordinary people. It can be a kind of respect or reverence for parents, grandparents, or people in a local place or country, or even for their own children. However, they still like to interfere and improve, pushing people on, like the Japanese expression gambaro, which means something like let's do our best, thinking they are doing something positive and loving for other people by cheering and pushing them on. But this obsession with correct performance and worthy activities has a damaging effect on health and societal sanity, since there is something artificial and excessive about it, creating unnecessary stress and burnout, as well as the pressure to replace authentic feelings with correct or appropriate feelings. It may be natural to Meritum types to be workaholics. Obviously, this energy exists for a reason. Just like some insect animals, like ants, work hard their entire lives. But not being a mental or emotional type, there is not much self-questioning in Meritum to ask why. For what purpose should we always strive and work harder? What's the end goal? With Meritum, it is not about basic needs and survival, it's not about health, and it's not about eventually having fun. It's about work for the sake of work, about improvement for the sake of improvement, about reaching a form of correctness and meritoriousness that is divorced from reality. They form an elite class of politicians and aristocrats that begin to admire and side with foreign leaders that are perceived as having more merits than their own people, then disregard what the people they serve want, and instead create new laws and norms to fix things that doesn't need fixing. Even when people don't like them, they don't seem to care, as they consider themselves superior and justified because of their hard work and merits. And the less they are loved, and the less they are able to simply enjoy and get nourished by life, the more they compensate by trying to improve even more and become more superior while criticizing others. Some of them will of course side with the people, because different Meritum types will have different ideas and values concerning what needs to improve. Some are conservative, some are liberal, and some are left-leaning and even into civil disobedience. But improving and fixing things always becomes an obsession to them that never seems to end. And when they fall short of some standard, they can feel unworthy unless they improve themselves. So the spiritual problem for Meritum tends to be a fixation on order, achievements, rules of conduct, and even rules of thinking and feeling, instead of being open to experience and letting natural processes flow. The spiritual strength is a high capacity for appreciation and respect, as well as the ability to strive hard and improve the culture when necessary, being disciplined and self-controlled, which can be useful in certain forms of spiritual practices.